very strange. The game started crashing very frequently in the last episodes. Учёчёно, чего? Stop following me. Yeah. That also impressed me back in the day how they all do that. They drink and eat and dance and play the drums, sweet. That is a bad spot they made here. You can't climb here and just cast rain of fire and take all of them out. Hooncha! Hoonch! Hoonch! Lost my... Nice, nice how they did all of that back then. Sweet. I mean, the big downfall about these headphones is that they really fall out like that. It's really disappointing. Otherwise, it's really great. It's those Logitech 933, I think, the Atemis Spectrum. What you want? What you want? So the spell he was talking about supposed to be in one of the chests. Let me check. I think it's this one. Into an orc dog. Healing, don't need light, don't need storm fire, don't need rain of fire, hell yeah. Fireball, need in there. Orc teleport spell, mana cost 5. So yeah, where was I? Just calls 3. No, I stopped Gothic Druid and the orcs, never mind. So, I'll go back just calls 3 sometime. Potion will take, heck yeah. The next, Bioshock. Now that's one, a good one. So the thing is, I was on the internet the other day and I heard a lot of people talking about this game and I was okay. And then more people were talking about it. I said, okay, knife, I will try this game. Let's see what it's all about. And I tried it and I played it a little bit and I was like, what the hell is that? Irish, what the hell is that? Where is that?
Irish? Irish? What the hell is that? Where is that?
Some kind of a wrench. You had to hit the splicers with a wrench. I mean, really? That's the game people was talking about and I didn't play it long enough, didn't like it. And I quit it very fast, didn't give it a chance. And I left the game and played other games, but people kept talking about it even more. I was reading more and more comments. I said, okay, you know what, I will give it another chance. Maybe I misjudged it a little bit too fast. And I went back in and took my time and I wanted to see what the game has to offer, and man, oh man, was I wrong about that game. I was highly impressed after that. Listening to the story, the setting, the plasmids, the weapons, the setting, the story, oh my god, I was blown away. I really enjoyed the combat in that game. It was sweet, the story and everything, the background, the recordings. I mean, the year it took time. There's the sword I was talking about that I wanted to get from here. Revenge Steel. That's a sexy ass sword. I don't know why it's not opening. And I think I finished Bioshock 1 like 4 times. No, it's 5. when their mastered version came out, I played it again, and they finished it another time, so it's 5. And I really enjoyed the game, and they released Bioshock 2 in 2010, and that game became my favorite game. Because I finished that game like 13 times, yeah guys, 13 times. Because I really like to experiment with all these plasmids and weapons, take different paths, bad and evil, or maybe in between. Because the game allows you to wield plasmid and weapon at the same time. I really dig that. And I really like the setting. It was phenomenal, everything about it. I really liked playing as a big daddy and experiment with everything. It was really fun. And I played the remastered version after that. The game looks gorgeous. And I finished it twice again. Completely good path, saving everyone, and another playthrough with completely bad, killing everyone. So yeah, 15 times finishing a game, I think I will put it to rest right now. Next, Devil May Cry. Well, should I expand on this? Because DMC, as I told in previous episodes, was my first Devil May Cry. I didn't know Devil May Cry even existed, and Devil May Cry existed since the 90s. So shame on me. But after that, I found out there is another Devil May Cry games. I watched the first Devil May Cry game because I no longer have access to it. They didn't release it on PC, unfortunately, but I didn't like the combat anyway because it was too simple for me after playing DMC. And I saw reviews of Devil May Cry 2, and I understand they really failed that game, they butchered it, they didn't do it as good as the first one, something like that. I'm looking for telekinesis to take that statue from up there, but let me say, because these suckers will attack me. But I did finish Devil May Cry 3 like 4 or 5 times, I don't remember, because I played through with every character. Lady, Trish, Dante, and of course, the save the best, Virgil. Hope it doesn't stuck in the textures. Oh my god, if it does. Figurine, let me look at it. Come. Little bit slower. Oh, and he backed out, unfortunate. Stop. Old game music. 500 experience. Wait. Garaged knock. I'll take it. Is that woo? Look at this. Yeah, it's a 200. I'll try it on the skeletons in the temple. And after that, it was good timing. Why? Because Devil May Cry 4 came out and it was a definitive edition with Virgil, so yeah. I really enjoyed playing as Virgil, as you've seen my katana. Unworthy opponents.
You're not worthy. My power shall be absolute.
I hope the orcs don't get mad at me. The warriors, at least. I think they did. Yeah, I'm in trouble. Yeah, I'm not even doing any... It's elite warriors, I think. Yeah, Orc Temple, yeah, that's very strong. The Devil May Cry 5 came out. Oh my goodness, can't wait to play it. It's very expensive. $60. Get strong. I don't know. I'm planning to do Gothic 2 Night of the Raven Let's Play because Gothic 1 won't be complete without Gothic 2. And after that, I'm planning to do Gothic 3 because I didn't play Gothic for 5 years. So, don't take my word for it. They want to do it, that's the plan anyway. The way they get pissed is funny. Statue moves the lever. So yeah, that's my experience with Devil May Cry and Borderlands. Well, Borderlands 2 was my first Borderlands game. The way I found out about it is I used to watch Force Gaming. Back in the day, he used to cast StarCraft 2 replays of pro players that playing against each other, and I really liked his voice, the way he narrates the strategies that the players use. My favorite faction is the Terrans. I really like the Terrans versus Zerg, or Terrans versus Protoss. It's time, it's Temple of the Sleeper. Are you ready? Let's head in. Now we... Temple of the Sleeper, look at this. I mean, when I was a kid, this game used to scare the shit out of me. I mean, I was coming here and like closing my eyes and running here as fast as I can to finish it. I was really scared of this place. The music, the setting, the undead, oh my god, I was so afraid. But now it ain't so bad. I really like it here. It's very mystical and magical. Now, this spell does come in handy here. Gonna make it faster, yeah? So like I saying about Borderlands, I saw him play the Borderlands in the 2011, and I really didn't see what he found about the game. But he gave the game the best game of the year. I was really surprised. I said, okay, if the game really that good, let me try it myself. And I really like first-person shooters, but this... That game I didn't really like. I didn't like the animations, I didn't like the shade scalings, the way they did it. I didn't like the reloading of the weapons. I thought it was really stupid, the way the characters were screaming and stuff. I said, what the hell, it's not a good FPS game. So I played like for 2 hours with the Metromancer and they left the game. Didn't like it at first at all. But then I played some other games and I said, you know what, let's go to Borderlands, give it another chance. And man, oh man, I give it another chance and I became hooked, literally.
Level up.
Look at them. Look at these Shaolin monks. Shaolin warriors trying to get in. Now there's some interesting puzzle here. Red, yellow and purple. I'm gonna take advantage of that glitch. I don't care. I didn't replenish my mana yet, really? Now there's a really good experience here. Let's see, there should be some potion here. I think it's dexterity. If you're ever in this temple, watch this let's play, by chance, come and take this potion. It gives dexterity. See? Plus 3. Nice. Now there's other interesting potions hidden here throughout. I think it's after you open the gate you will get access to them. Ravage Steel, I wanted that weapon and it's really worse than my warrior's voice. Gomez has a really nice sword. His sword does 110 damage. Looks who found me. At last. Stormfist. Should use it more. Telekinesis, let me see. There might be some torches. Yeah. I don't know, they never managed to fix those things. They just put them in the air like this. Let me try something here. Get on this lamp and then... Yeah, I don't think it's gonna happen. Switch, lol. Yep, there are a couple of potions up there and the X. Nice X, but really too weak for this point in the game. Where is it? Smash. Yeah, I'll smash. Smash or pass? Smash. For sure. Now I'm gonna lure another unsuspecting victim over here. Temple Mindcrawler, is he strong yet? The same experience, I think. So yeah, and after that I came to Borderlands again and I got hooked. I really put all of my time and finished all the DLCs back at the time. Where are the skeletons? Strange. strange. There's supposed to be skeletons here. Very strange. Fucking scary, bro. Dead space all over again. So after I played Borderlands 2 for so long, I said to myself, let's go and check Borderlands 1. I checked it and it was inferior, but I still liked it. I finished it with Break, with all the DLCs. I played it only once, tried the new game plus, but it was too stale. I didn't see the another reason to play it. I didn't had the motivation to do it again. Wasn't really into it for another run. The final level I think was 52 or 53, something like that. So yeah, I'm eagerly waiting for Borderlands 3. I really want that game. As soon as it comes, I will buy it. I mean, I'm not gonna wait it for it to drop in price. The skeletons are back. Now, what was it? Yellow, red, purple, yeah? Some light wouldn't hurt, would you say? Would you agree? Yeah, much better. And I know, like I said, I really liked Assassin's Creed and played all the games, but I didn't talk about them because they are not in my saves, but I'm still going to. Alright, sweet, nothing hard about it really. So I don't remember how I got introduced into Assassin's Creed 1. Maybe I was looking for Prince of Persia games and that's how I stumbled upon Assassin's Creed the first. I played it, I really liked it, it was really interesting, it looks gorgeous. But the story was really amazing, but after a couple of times it got stale. From like between middle and the end, it got boring because it was the same thing every location. Go gather info. Beat the information of this NPC, eavesdrop on this. And then go assassinate your target, wait in the crowd to get the opportunity. It got stale very fast. I finished the game like two times, maybe three times at most. Can't tell you for sure, but two times is decent enough, I believe. Bloodblade. I think Gothic 2 they renamed it to Blood Dragon or something, or Dragon Slayer. Not long after that Assassin's Creed 2 came out, and man, oh man, what a game. That is my favorite game of all in the series. I mean, they improved on everything. Your character can swim now. Even when he gets out of water, he's wet and there's still water dripping from him and he looks all shiny. That's really sweet. They made more ways to assassinate your targets, brought two hidden blades at the same time. Brought poison. That was really sweet. I think brought some berserk. That was really funny. You could fly. You get to see Leonardo da Vinci with his creations and stuff. That game is the best in the series. My favorite. I even have this beautiful t-shirt with Ezio. With Ezio, but that's for another time. That will be in the next episode. There, if you come here, before you get access to that room over there, you can get here and climb. Here you will get a nice potion. If you never knew about it, here is the little neat secret. I think it's a potion plus 6 to dexterity and strength. I will check it in a second to see if my brain still serves me. No, it's plus 4. Okay. Sweet. Let's see. There's any enemies? I remember a skeleton mage. Oh, there he be. Now what I really don't need in here. Light I will keep. Lightning bolt is nice. Rain of fire I never use. I'll go with the undead. Now there's always a problem on the back here to get somehow up there. But if you can do it, there's really good potions. I don't know, I think they somehow did a mistake here with the height. Let me see if I have some mushrooms on me. If I can drop some mushrooms to the ground, I can get a jump boost. Still not enough. Let me try something taller, maybe a mushroom like I said. Wait. Too close. Well, come on. Damn it. Need something taller than that. What can it be? Maybe some herbs? Maybe... Maybe swamp weed. Well, that seems like high. Let me see. Yes! Alright. Now. Let me light the fire. Let there be light. If you head there is really nice potions. Permanent stats. See? They're hidden here in the corner. I think it's a dexterity or something. Yeah, plus 5. That's a nice boost. Another potions, look at this. Another dexterity? No, mana plus 10. Sweet. Oh, and the bonus life. Elixir of life, bonus for maximum life plus 15. Sweet. So there's little secrets and chances. I know how many people bashed on my Gothic 3 video, nice secret that they made long ago. My PC really sucked back then. I mean, it was what, 2007? My PC was really bad, unlike now. Back then I was still at school, I didn't have the money to buy my own PC like I did now with two 1080 Ti's. My mom bought that PC for me and she couldn't allow herself to upgrade my PC every time new game came out. So I put a couple of grand into this PC to last me for 5 years at least. That's my estimate.
But can it run Crysis?
Next, we were talking about Assassin's Creed, so Assassin's Creed 3 is my favorite game. After that came Brotherhood, and I really liked it. It took place in Rome.